Hello and welcome to Wisdom Included. I'm Shelley Carney. This is a collaborative gathering place especially for women to share personal stories, support, and advice, Wisdom Included. It's Tuesday tryouts where I'll be testing, reporting, reviewing, and recommending podcasts, books, events, speakers, courses, apps, and products that I find especially helpful or encouraging. In a recent video, Schedule Your Priorities, I mentioned that I use Google Calendar to keep my schedule so I can remember appointments and be on time. With family members, friends, and colleagues always on the go, the Google Calendar is a great way to stay connected. Today, I'm going to walk you through the Google Calendar app and demonstrate how it functions and keeps me on track. Keep in mind, there are many ways to use any app. I'll be showing you how I use it and what works best for me. I hope that it will work for you and your family as well. First, begin with a Gmail account. Then, access the apps by clicking on the box in the top right corner and choose Calendar. If you have more than one Gmail account, each account will have a separate calendar, which you may want if you have a business or family calendar that you want to keep isolated or private from the other. There are a variety of display options across the top, so you can focus on just one day, the week, or the whole month. There's also a customized button you can adjust in settings for the length of time that works best for you. You can look at it as a calendar or an agenda if you just want a list of events. Click on the gear to change the look or access settings. On the left side, there is a quick create button to add an event. Or you can click on the day and time when the event will start and create the event there. When you do that, you can open a more detailed page to put in the location and description and any reminders or notes you might need. Putting in the address and the location will make it easier to set a reminder on your phone that tells you what time you need to leave to arrive on time, and you can pull up the navigation app when you need the directions while driving. You can also invite other people through their Gmail, and they will get an invitation. When they accept the invitation, it will add the event to their calendar, and they will have all the information you entered in the description. Click the down arrow next to your calendar name to change the settings and color and to share your calendar. Under your calendar name, you can add tasks, or you can schedule reminders. Tasks can be a simple to-do list, or you can add a due date, which puts them on the calendar for that day, and you can add notes to them. Reminders are added to the calendar and can be repeated. Other calendars gives you the opportunity to add calendars such as holidays and the calendars of your friends. You decide the color for each different calendar. I know that my calendar is purple, my daughter is light blue, my son is dark blue, my husband is green, and my business partner is red. When I have all of the calendars grouped into one, it is very easy to know what times are open if I need to schedule appointments with or for anyone in my family or business. Very often, other apps that help you schedule events, such as Meetup and Facebook, will either automatically add events to your calendar or they will prompt you to do so. Having the Google Calendar app on your phone allows you to sync your calendar and any calendars that have been shared with you as you choose. So when you have an event scheduled, a notification will appear on your phone to remind you if you have that feature enabled. When I get into the car to drive to a meeting, I pull up my calendar, click on the event, click the address, and my navigation opens to give me driving directions. There are online tutorials provided by Google if you want more information, but I know that it helps to hear from a friend how best to use something, and that can give you helpful ideas. If you use the Google Calendar app and have further helpful hints, or you have a suggestion for another similar app, let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. If this is your first time here, please take a moment to subscribe. I'll continue to post new videos several times each week featuring personal stories, support, and advice, wisdom included.